again, young scientists. Justin here. Last time I saw you, we were finishing up our exploration of the pond, and today, we finally made it to a much larger and saltier body of water. The ocean. Wow. I mean, look at this view. The long trip was worth it just to be able to see this. Today, we're gonna learn a little bit about the ocean, how it's different from the pond we've already explored, and see if we can discover what lives in that beautiful blue water. So, are you ready to dive into learning all about the body of water down there and the creatures that live within it? Let's go! Like I said, this giant body of water is called an ocean. Did you know that oceans cover about 71% of the Earth's surface? That's way more than half. They're home to so many diverse habitats too. And unlike the pond where our freshwater friends live, this water is very salty. You don't want to drink this stuff. Do you remember what a biome is? A biome is a community of plants and animals that live in the same area. The pond we explored was a freshwater biome because the plants and animals there all live in or around fresh water. Since the ocean is full of salty water, it's called a saltwater biome. It's a community of plants and animals that live in and around salt water. Saltwater biomes have a few specific characteristics that make them very different from freshwater biomes, like the pond. One of the most fascinating things about the ocean is its salinity. That's a fancy word for how salty the water is. The ocean's salinity comes from minerals washed down from rocks on land, like the big rocks we're standing on. These minerals, especially salt, dissolve in streams and rivers and travel to the ocean, making it salty. As we know, the pond did not have very much salt in its water, and because of that, the ocean and pond have a very different set of inhabitants, or plants and animals that live there. The ocean's temperature is also unique. This water doesn't have the same temperature everywhere like a pond does. Near the equator, the sun warms the water up, making it nice and toasty. But as you travel north or south towards the poles, the water gets really cold. These temperature differences affect where different creatures can live. Warm waters are great for coral reefs, while cooler waters are home to animals like penguins and seals. Last but not least, let's talk about depth. The pond wasn't very deep. Mia could travel all the way to the bottom pretty quickly. The ocean, however, has many layers. Each layer has its own set of living conditions and inhabitants. The top layer, where sunlight reaches, is full of life, including plants and fish. But as you go deeper, the sunlight fades, and the water pressure increases too. Despite these challenges, life thrives at all depths, adapted to the dark and the pressure. Each of these factors plays a crucial role in creating homes for the amazing variety of life found in saltwater biomes. Let's move closer so we can look around and see what lives close to the shore. Ah, finally, we made it to the beach. I remember seeing a lot of plants growing by the ponds. Do you think plants can grow in the ocean too? Mia, are you ready to dive in? Ah, I knew there had to be some plants around here. Seagrasses form underwater meadows in shallow, sunny parts of the ocean. These plants are very good at photosynthesis, the process of converting sunlight and carbon dioxide into oxygen and energy. Seagrasses are important habitats that offer homes and food to a lot of animals, including fish, sea turtles, and invertebrates. Their root systems help keep the seabed stable, which prevents erosion and keeps the water clear. This is key for the health of their neighbors, coral reefs. And algae, like this kelp, also has a big job. Kelp grows in huge underwater forests that provide homes and food for lots of animals. Just like aquatic plants, algae is very good at photosynthesis. It absorbs a lot of carbon dioxide, which helps our whole planet. These colorful things called corals also live nearby. They may look like rocks, or maybe plants, but they're actually made up of animals called polyps. They build huge reefs that provide homes for thousands of other living things and protect the coastline from erosion, or wearing away over time. Whoa, what is this cool thing? Is it an animal? Mia, can you help me out with this? Wow, it is! It's a sea urchin. Do you think it's a vertebrate or an invertebrate? Huh. This sea urchin doesn't look like it can move very much at all. It definitely doesn't have a defined body shape or separate arms and legs. It's just a spiky ball. And look what I found washed up on the shore. It's a sand dollar. It too has no limbs and doesn't really seem to move. Looks like these are both invertebrates that live in the ocean. Sea urchins and sand dollars do have jobs though. They provide food for bigger animals, control the algae population, and even help to clean the sand on the ocean floor. And of course, there are fish of all shapes, sizes, and colors that live here. Those are vertebrates with a backbone, just like us. I don't know about you, but I've learned so much about how all of the living creatures in the ocean help each other and even us. But that's just near the... Whoa, look at that! Whoa. Yeah, we definitely need to find a way to get further out to sea. I need to know what that was. Remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers... Mia, we gotta find a boat. Who? Hey!